Hey, Justin, tell me if this is true. I'm going to walk through a few different points and do some math. You tell me if each one of these statements is true. First off, this $4,200 right here is kept, right? That doesn't disappear anywhere. That's real money sitting in an account somewhere. And it's not part of this $12,000 right here. It is its own 4,200 bucks. So this 4,200 comes back to me, the investor. Now, 6,000 of that I pass on. So the other 6,000 I have to pay tax on. I am reducing my taxes by 2,100 because I passed on this 6,000, which means I do have to pay $2,100 on this 6,000. 6,000 minus the 2,100 that I have to pay in taxes should be the 3,900, right? Yeah. So now I have $3,900 right here. I still have $4,200 over here, right? And without getting too much into the weeds, let's just go ahead and figure that we have the $6,000 that went back into the policy, because we will. Don't worry so much about the cost of borrowing that money out. Just know that you paid a premium that year and you got 150% of the premium that you paid in increase. So to keep things simple, let's say that the $6,000 that goes back into our policy, let's say that we actually get that. And later we can talk about the details if you want, but it's pretty close to $6,000 that we would actually get more if you factor in all this other stuff. So we have this 6,000, we have this 39, and we have this 42. And if we add all that together, 4,200 plus the 3,900 plus the 6,000, son of a gun, if we don't get $14,100. So, Dan did the math a little bit differently. When I spoke to him, he said, I was just trying to keep this as simple as possible for people. He's a concept guy, not a numbers guy. When he started teaching this concept 18, 19 years ago, he had a pen and a yellow pad of paper and a calculator in his pocket, maybe. So, he's taught the concept and he's seen the concept proven over and over. When I asked him a couple of questions about this, he said that when he goes through this with somebody, he knows that business owner is making money. He knows the business owner has money in other places and might just be paying the tax that he has to pay on the 6,000. Maybe he pays that out of some other account that he's got, reaches into his pocket, comes up with that money, whatever. So as I went through this, though, the key thing that I want to make sure about, make sure you and I are both on the same page here. This 4,200 doesn't disappear. It's real money and it is there. This $3,900 is real money and it is in my pocket. This $6,000 is real money and it's in my other pocket. I've got three pockets. And if I add all three of them up, I've got $14,100. And I'm pretty sure I'm right about that. Give me your thoughts.